So let's talk about seller credits. What are they and how do they work? I'm here to tell you how to make this work for you, whether you're a buyer, an agent, or a seller. My name is Heidi Knowlton and I'm a realtor and I love everything about real estate. Subscribe to my channel to get notified when a new video comes out if you like to learn things all about real estate. After I tell you all about seller credits, at the end I'm going to give you a tip on how to get the other side on board with your seller credit. I've been in real estate since 2004 and I've done some pretty creative negotiating when it comes to the seller credit. So first, let's talk about what it is. The seller credit is basically when you are going to finance part of your closing costs, or maybe you're financing all of your closing costs. If the buyer is financing additional money, then why is it called a seller credit? Well, the seller has to agree to it, first of all, but also you're adding your closing costs into the purchase price, which means the seller also has to agree to that. So essentially what you're doing is you're adding money to the purchase price, usually, not always, but let's say you're adding money to the purchase price and then the seller has to agree to give you some of that money back during closing. So that's why the seller has to be involved and the seller has to agree to this. There are also instances where you're not adding more value to the purchase price to get money back. Let's say you're not in a multiple offer situation. The house is listed for $300,000, but you want to have $10,000 back to go towards closing costs. In that case, the seller still has to be involved and agree to giving you $10,000 back to go towards your closing costs. So either way, the seller has to be involved and the seller has to agree. So here's an example. Let's say the purchase price is $300,000 and you want to get $10,000 back from the seller. The seller at the end of the day is going to see $290,000 to him. That is his net number, and $10,000 is going to you. And the bank also has to agree to this. The bank has to agree that you're going to finance $300,000 and that you're going to get $10,000 back to go towards your costs. So always make sure that the lender is involved and ask this question ahead of time. How much can I get and am I allowed to use it for this purpose? So let's say that you're in a situation where you have multiple offers, but you still need closing costs. So you could then raise your purchase price. So let's say you raise it to $305,000 and the listing price is $300,000. You still ask for $10,000 back, and then your bottom line to the seller is $295,000. The only catch to this is you've got to make sure that the house will appraise. So make sure you talk with your realtor, get a plan together, make sure you look at all the comps, and if you offer above asking price, make sure that the house can appraise for that, that higher price. So how common is a seller credit? I went back through the data and I went back 30 days in my area and it turns out about 22% had seller concessions. So it's not really a common thing right now. And that's because it's a seller's market right now out here that a lot of buyers just aren't asking for seller credits. So of the 22% that had a seller credit, most of them were about $5,000 and under. There were a couple that hit $10,000 and $18,000, but those are obviously going to be higher priced homes. So usually when asking for a seller credit, you talk to your lender to figure out how much you really need. And you can start with asking for 3%, or if you only need 1%, maybe ask for just 1%. But really, it just depends on your financial situation and what you can get the seller to agree to. So I'd love to know, are you a buyer, an agent, or a seller? Be sure to comment below, let me know. So when you're talking with neighbors and it comes up, you know, you wanna know what their house sold for, and they'll say, oh, it sold for $500,000, or oh, it sold for $200,000. Well, you wanna know if there are any concessions. So what really matters is what's the net number that they got for their house. If they sold their house for $500,000 and they got $15,000 in concessions, you're gonna wanna know that because that affects the value and how much he actually sold his house for. So that's an important question. What was the net offer? So here's my tip when it comes to getting a seller credit. Make sure you ask a lot of questions. You need to talk to the seller, to the buyer, and to the agent. You need to go directly to the seller and find out what is he looking for? What's important to him? And you need to do these things before you write the offer. I know sometimes it's tempting to get into a rush. We want to hurry and submit our offer without thinking about these things, but it's really important that you have a conversation with the seller and the agent and find out what that seller wants. And it's also important to talk to your lender. You need to know what's allowed and what's not allowed because that can really throw off the whole deal. So here's an important question to ask. You need to find out if there's multiple offers. That way you can put your offer together in a really well-informed way, in a way that will appeal to your seller. If there's multiple offers, maybe you don't want to ask for any seller credit because maybe you'll have the upper hand if you don't ask for any seller credit. But if you do ask for a seller credit when there's multiple offers, make sure you're going above the purchase price. So one question to not ask is to go to the seller and say, can I ask for a seller credit? Will you agree to a seller credit? Because the seller doesn't know. He doesn't have enough information from you as a buyer. He hasn't seen your offer. There's so many different areas to look at on an offer besides the seller credit to know if it really is a good offer, because you could write a really strong offer and ask for seller credit, and the seller may be more willing to take your seller credit request because your offer is so good. But if you have a weak offer and then you're also asking for seller credit, your chances of getting the house are a little bit lower because you didn't come forward with a really strong offer. So it's really important to ask the seller what is important to them when you write their offer. Maybe the seller wants to be able to rent back for a short time because they've got other things to take care of and they don't want to move in quickly. Maybe it's the holidays and they would like some extra time to get out of their house. Another negotiating point is repairs. Maybe you agree to not ask for any repairs if they'll give you a seller credit in exchange. So there's many different ways to tailor your offer so it's good for you, and it also will appeal to the seller, and they'll look at your offer over another buyer's offer. Sometimes you're dealing with a seller that doesn't want to give up any money for seller credit, and unfortunately that does happen. I go back to my other point of asking the seller, what do they want? What would it take for you to be able to give me $5,000 back? Maybe you asked for $10,000 and now you've lowered it to $5,000. What would it take for you to agree with this? And maybe you tell them, look, we've saved up money, we have money in the bank, but we want to use it to put in new carpet in the house. So trying to relate with the seller, have a conversation with the seller, or it's most likely the listing agent that you have this conversation with, but just try and go back and forth, negotiate, see what the seller wants, and try to appeal to him to see if you can come to an agreement. Seller credits are a strong negotiating point, and it's really important that you have someone good working for you to negotiate with the other side so you get what you want. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with anybody who you think it might help. See you next time.